Your boy Max Rod back with some Fishing Planet. Sitting out here in Alberta. Finna try to catch me some uniques out here. Got my boat. Gonna take a gander at that old pole there. We are with the Christmas poles out here again. Going with 16 foot crankbaits, 4-aught 16 footers. I'm going with these right here and the one I have on. I'm going 16 foot everything, really. We'll try this one. Okay. I'm gonna fish with it anyways. I think I was fishing with it yesterday and it casts pretty good. Let's see what it casts like. It's pretty good. But in fact, they were wrong. And it was very plain and obvious that anyone had done. See if we can pull this one. I really just need some money. I'm gonna try to just sit here and fill up my nets. Going a little broke. So we're gonna get out here and see what we can get a hold of. First cast, no good. Down from there that you talked about a great vast city called Manti. 12 foot 2 out, and no wonder I got the wrong thing out there. But 12 and 16 foot ain't too much of a difference. Maybe it is, we'll see. See if I can catch something. Try the same one for 16 foot. A little bigger hook. Oh no, that's not the same color either. I thought I had all those. Need to go back to the main store and see how come I don't have those other two. There's 2 4-aught 16 or some missing. Thought I bought all of them. Seems like 12 would work better. And there through Wisconsin you'll see the narrow strip of land. Of course, according to the Book of Mormon, right at that
Thing don't want to lift up.
Just to the south of it was a great fast city that was built. Book Mormon doesn't give it a name, but probably somewhere between Detroit and Indianapolis. I think maybe some archaeologists should go up there and take a little look-see, because where Joseph said that the city of Manti was, exactly where it is, someone might also want to go take a look at that location there where he said Zarahemla was. Because you see, the geography was very, very clear.
That's it. And
there's a lot more that you don't know. Yes.
I'm in love.
A lot of people think, oh, well, Joseph Smith knew he had a map of the United States. Maybe he just made all that up and said, see, here you go, and he just made all this up. But, you see, he couldn't have just made this up.
Oh, there my boat is.
He could not have known.
Nice.
But in the Book of Mormon, the American Indians were actually the lost tribes of Israel, and they actually spoke Hebrew. And so, if he was right, then the people that lived in this country before the Europeans arrived must have spoken Hebrew, and we ought to be able to find evidence for that. And in fact, we do. Yes, we actually do.
Can we get some luck?
About this in some of my prior research, but a lot of American Indians today not really aware of this. If you go back a few hundred years and you do a little excavation, you'll find that the ancient Indians upon this continent did indeed speak Hebrew. They dug up little sarcophaguses and some of these mounds and found Hebrew writing right there on the sarcophagus in the ancient artifacts that they're digging. They found, along with the Indian
pictograms
up and down the canyons in New Mexico, to find Hebrew writing. Not far from where I live in New Mexico, there's actually a large plateau-like mountain. Kind of resembles, you know, something that you might expect to see if you were looking for Zion, or perhaps the Mount Sinai or something. It's right out in the desert here, south of Albuquerque. And on the top of that mountain, there's an altar with the name of Yahweh written in paleographic Hebrew. At the base of that mountain, there's a large stone, very, very large, as big as a...
Can we hook in anything?
Bigger than maybe a motorhome. And upon that stone, in paleographic...
Sunny day, might have to change colors, I don't know.
...dated to 106 B.C. is the Ten Commandments. There's various ways in which you can prove that that stone is authentic. But that's not all, friends. From that point all the way up the valley through New Mexico and on into Colorado, through the Purgatory Canyon, there are Hebrew hieroglyphs, paleographic writing. Well, on top of that, some of you might have read a book that was published some years ago called Ishi.
Don't know what that was.
Book that was written about a man who was the last of the Indians there in California. The white man went in there in the gold rush days and they were doing all this mining and so forth. And they had hunted down all the Indians and killed them. It was like one Indian that was finally found, the last one. They didn't kill that one. They were ordered to take him down to their Butte County jail and they stuck him in there. Of course, they couldn't talk to him. They didn't know what, you know, kind of a language he spoke. They brought a linguistic individual in to sit and see if maybe they could figure out what language this guy spoke. So he tried everything and finally said a word in Hebrew. The guy kind of poked up and looked at him. He determined that the Indians in California spoke Hebrew because in Hebrew, Ishi means man. And when he asked him his name, because the Indians of that area do not give you their name, but they only say, I am a man. And so he said, I am Ishi. So that was the name that stuck, and there were books written about that. But from all sides, we have vast archaeological evidence that the Indians of ancient days that lived in America did indeed. But there's something even more interesting. According to Joseph Smith, the Indians that lived in this land came over as tribes of Israel, so they originally spoke the language of Hebrew. But according to Joseph Smith, they had gone through certain areas down through Egypt and spent some time there. And on this journey, their language evolved just a little bit and picked up a few Greek, Egyptian type, Phoenician basic kind of appearances. So, kind of like English, you know, and how it changes from Old English to New English. So this particular language of these particular people changed just slightly from the ancient paleographic Hebrew to a more Phoenician-based type paleographic language. And indeed, this is the language that you find on the rock there in Las Lunas, New Mexico, with the paleographic writing there. We've done the research and we've looked at it and we've said, well, this is very close to Hebrew, but there's a strange slant to this. It's kind of a little, you know, like a few Greek-type Phoenician letters thrown in. Exactly what Joseph Smith said. Of course, this rock is there. You know, Joseph Smith had never gone there. He never knew anything about it because he lived out there in Missouri, in Illinois, in New York. Never went to New Mexico, as far as we know. And it's been proven that this rock could not have been forged in paleographic Hebrew because no one at that time in the 1800s, and there's very clear, you know, scribbles on the rocks that people in the 1800s went over there and saw. The Indians of that area say they didn't write it. It was there 400 years ago, long before they arrived. Right? There's quite a bit of evidence that we probably need to do a little more research and a little more investigating about the Book of Mormon, because everything that's written in there is very, very important for us today. But anyway, there are literally, you know, hundreds of things that we can talk about when it comes to Joseph Smith. And I really didn't make this video to talk about Joseph Smith, but to talk about this great
gonna work too well there. Thinking. Yeah, still didn't make it to the bottom now. Damn, that water's deep. What will the Shiner do? Not vibrating.
Hi.
What's up? Not catching any fish, it makes me sleepy. If I can catch me a few fish here, give me a little change in my pocket. Especially if I could use some minnows, that'd be alright. Got a nice date. So I should catch me a few fish. Need to find me a good lure that works.
Ipu can use those minnows to get the salmon, just cast to your right and at a depth of 6-0 inches should be good, emoji wink.
For sure. get us one. What the hell is going on here? Deeper. Uh-oh. Is it a perch? Get my XP up, get me a smaller pole out in that water. Watch me catch a big fish, can't pull it in. Uniqueness. Can I pull out a unique real quick? Out of 51 small minnows, how many uniques can I get out of a long day of high time fishing? How many trophies? Not looking too good. I'm getting so sleepy. I didn't think I was sleepy until I laid down and started playing the game. Corner. I like that corner right there.